in just 7 minutes,
let's write a script to compare transaction processing speeds across 5 different blockchains. So if you've spent any time on crypto Twitter lately, you've probably noticed quite a few posts popping up about the speed of transactions across different blockchains. This is an important topic because some projects require the fastest possible transactions to enable their use case. This isn't the case for everybody, as every blockchain offers a different tech stack and enables different possibilities. But for some projects, the difference between processing a transaction in 1 second and 20 seconds can make or break their application. So this is why today, across Solana, Ethereum, Arbitrum, Polygon, and Binance Smart Chain, we're going to send 5 different transactions, one to each of these chains, and measure the time it takes for that transaction to be confirmed, and then compare. So let's jump into it. So remember, the goal here is to essentially send the transaction on 5 different blockchains and then measure the amount of time that it takes for that transaction to process and be confirmed. So what this will entail is, number one, defining 5 different RPC endpoints and thus connecting to 5 different blockchains. We'll need to define some accounts. And then, of course, we'll need to actually build the transactions themselves and push them to the network, and then measure the amount of time that it takes for these transactions to process. So we can get started by importing some of our base packages. This will be Solana web3.js, Base58 for the private key decoding, web3.js for the EVM chains, and performance for measuring the amount of time that it takes for a transaction to process. Okay, so now that we have all of our libraries imported, we can go ahead and define some of our base variables that we'll be using to connect to the blockchain itself. So we'll make an independent variable for Ethereum, Binance Smart Chain, Arbitrum, Polygon, and Solana, and insert an RPC URL for all of these. So before we do that, we'll first need to go ahead and launch 5 different RPC nodes on Chainstack. So I'm now on the Chainstack console. I'm going to go ahead and go into my test 3 project, click get started and join a network. So I'll start with Solana, click on Solana mainnet, and next. I'll launch this on Chainstack Cloud in Ashburn. I'll launch another node for Polygon now. This one will deploy a globally load balanced Elastic full node and join network. We'll do our Ethereum node as well. For this one, we'll also deploy just a standard global node. Now we can do one for Binance Smart Chain and join network. And then finally, we'll also do one for Arbitrum. Okay, so now we have a node for Arbitrum, Binance Smart Chain, Ethereum, Polygon, and Solana. So let's throw these into our code and get started. So I went ahead and defined 5 variables. So let's now go ahead and define 2 different Solana accounts. Number one, the sender, and number two, the recipient. So of course, for the sender, we'll need the private key. So we can first define a variable called Solana private key. If you watched my video on sending a transaction with Solana Web3.js, you'll probably recognize the same workflow. So in this case, we'll have to create a new uintate array. And in here, we can call our base58 library and the decode method. And then here we can throw in our environment variable for the private key. We can also go ahead and define Solana account, which will derive an account from the private key that we just defined. We can call Solana 03.key pair. And then here we can throw in our Solana private key variable. We'll also want to go ahead and generate a fresh Solana account to be the recipient of the transaction. We can just name this Sol recipient account. Let's also define our EVM account. For this one, we can call any of our EVM connection variables. I'll just use Ethereum Web3 in this case. And here we can throw in our environment variable for our EVM private key. And then here we can also create another variable of the recipient address for the EVM transactions. So let's now define our 2 primary functions here. This will be send EVM transaction and send Solana transaction. Let's start with send EVM transaction. This will be asynchronous and will take 4 different variables. These variables will be Web3, from account, to pub key, and network name. Okay, so now that we've opened up this function, we can go ahead and define a few key variables that'll be within our transaction. These variables will be transaction count, gas price, and chain ID. And then here we can just very simply call web3.eth.getTransactionCount, and then we can throw in our from account.address. We can also define the gas price. This will just be web3.eth.getGasPrice, and of course the chain ID as well. All right, so now that we have these variables defined, let's go ahead and build our transaction itself. We'll name this signTX and call the signTransaction method on the fromAccount object. And here we can throw in our transaction details, such as to public key. We can do the value as well. In this case, it'll just be 0. We can define the gas. For peer-to-peer, address-to-address transactions, this will just be 21,000. We can throw in gas price. We can define the knots, which is the transaction count variable. So now we have a signed transaction that's ready to be pushed to the network. So first, before we actually send the transaction, let's go ahead and start a timer, basically. We'll just name this start and set it equal to performance.now. Okay, now that the timer is started, we can go ahead and send the transaction to the network. It'll be web3.eth.send signed transaction. We can do the signed tx.raw transaction. And then here, once we send the transaction, we'll want to wait for the receipt. So we'll want to wait until this transaction is processed and confirmed on the blockchain. So we can just do that with .once the receipt. Essentially in here, what we're going to be doing is waiting until there is a transaction receipt, until it's confirmed. And then we can log something here that will tell us the amount of time that it took to do that. Let's open up the console.log. We can throw in our network name, say transaction, confirmation time. And here we can actually calculate the amount of time that it took. So now that we have defined our send EVM transaction function, we can move on to Solana. Solana will be a little bit simpler because we're only doing this to one network. So we don't have to define all the extra function parameters like we did for the EVM one. Let's start by defining the transaction itself. We'll call this sol transaction. It'll be a new instance of Solana web3.transaction. In the parameters of this method, we can throw in Solana web3.systemprogram. And then in here, we can throw in our transaction parameters. So this will just be from pubkey, Solana account.publicKey. We can do to pubkey, which will be the recipient account that we generated, and then the value. Of course, we define the value in LAN ports. All right, so now similar to the other function, we can go ahead and start our stopwatch just by defining a start variable. And we go ahead and push the transaction to the network by defining a signature variable. And here we can include the transaction object. Okay, so now we need to basically find out when this transaction gets processed and print out the time that it takes to do that. I'm gonna take the easy route here and go purely by the signature status, but there's a multitude of ways that you can go about doing this. So in this case, I'm going to first define a result variable, and then I'm going to open a do while loop. Here I'll define results, Solana connection, again, our RPC node, signature status, the signature that we defined above. We're going to do this while the value of result is null. So again, this isn't the best way of doing it. This will rack up quite a few RPC requests, but it's an easy way to continually pull the signature status until we have a complete transaction. We go ahead and log the time that it took to do that. All right, so perfect. We have now imported all of our libraries, defined all of our RPC node connections, defined our accounts, defined the function that will send the EVM transactions, as well as the Solana transaction. So now it's time to figure out how fast each blockchain is. We're going to call the EVM function for each of our different blockchains, as well as the Solana function. And let's go ahead and run it. So you can see so far we have Solana, Arbitrum, BSC, and Polygon that have confirmed and finished their transaction. All right, so now we have Ethereum as well. So as you can see, Solana processed basically this confirmation. What this just means is that the transaction went through and the receipt returned that it was processed. That was about 1 second. Arbitrum was about 1.5 seconds, 2 seconds for Binance Smart Chain, almost 5 seconds for Polygon, and about 19 seconds for Ethereum. So it's a pretty interesting comparison. These times will change depending on network conditions and whatnot, but they're interesting numbers nonetheless. So now you know the process of sending a transaction across 4 different EVM chains, as well as Solana. If you'd like to watch more Byte-Size Building videos, then you can do so with the link below.